A very good morning to all of you. I am really thankful to Rayat Shikshan Sansthas, C.D. Jain College of Commerce, Shrirampur, for inviting me as a chief guest for valedictory function for faculty development program on educational video creation and e-content development from 3rd August to 8th August. Today is the last day of faculty development program. And I'm very happy to share with you all the resource person, they really did excellent job. I have just gone through some of the videos created and some of the digital tools they shared with the participants. It is really wonderfully done. So thankful to IQSE coordinator, Mr. Vivek More sir, and his whole team and the principal of the college for having me here. So my dear friends, educational video creation and e-content development is something that we have to learn every day for a better future, because there is a transformation going to happen in the field of education. When I say transformation, that means the illiterate of the 21st century will not be those who cannot read and write, but those who cannot learn, unlearn, and relearn. This is a quote by Alvin Toffler, and very wonderfully he has said this, that whatever we have learned, we have to unlearn and we have to relearn. So this is the situation given by COVID-19, or we can say education 4.0, the new generation of education, the new revolution of education, where we have to cope up with new challenges of education and we have to go with the time to face the challenges of online teaching learning process. So you have just completed the faculty development program about developing e-content and how to create the videos. So I will not go in detail of all these technical things. Let us first understand and ask yourself, so what next? I have completed this FDP. Ask yourself, are we doing webinars or online courses for sake of certificate or for real implementation? This is very crucial questions, my dear friends, because when we think of that, if I do any particular online course and I'm very sincerely involved in it, I must implement all those things in real classroom situation with my students. And that is a basic responsibility every teacher has, that whenever I learn something new, whenever I do something, I must implement to my students. So this faculty development program has definitely given you some inputs about creating videos and about developing e-content. But how this e-content you are going to implement in your school or college? That is my question to all of you. Just think on it. If we teach today the way we taught yesterday, we aren't preparing students for today or tomorrow. Because I have seen many of the teachers, they are not ready to accept the challenge of this online teaching. Many people, they are sharing that this will not help. There might be some health issues to the students. I have seen some newspaper articles also who were opposing online teaching. But we have to think in a positive manner. We have to take in other way. The thing is that when everything is changing and our new generation who is sitting in front of us in the classroom situation, they are more smarter, they are more techno-savvy. So it is our role or responsibility of a teacher to be that techno-savvy to face the challenges of future generations. And we have to understand student psychology from primary to higher education. Most of the participants from you might be teaching in pre-primary, primary school, secondary, or in higher education. So whatever class you are teaching, whatever standard you are teaching, the first thing, try to understand the age group of the children. How much attention span they have? How much memory span they have? If I put some video in front of the students and I share some e-content, what exactly the psychological need of a student and what I'm exactly providing, that we have to understand first. Because nowadays students are learning fast. They learn technology better than us because younger generation is more smarter. No school has given them how to use electronic gadgets, but they are learning by themselves. they are using by themselves, and it is very much possible that future generations will come up with all these new ideas, and we have to face these challenges because we have to be ready to face for new challenges. Younger generation is more smart, you all know that. So if we think of evolution of learning using technology in teaching learning, right from blackboard or chalkboard, we shifted to whiteboard and marker, then transparency slide. I remember in last few years, I was using overhead projectors and PowerPoint presentations. Nowadays, I think that those were very, very basic technologies I was using. We shifted to CAI, that is computer-assisted instructions, web-based learning teaching tools, video conferencing, e-classroom, wireless technology. And now this is a situation where we have to learn with and teach with innovative technology. My dear friends, we are in the era of education 4.0. Let me tell you what exactly it is. Like industry 4.0, there is always a revolution in the field of education. This figure is given by Thailand Cyber University. In the first generation of education, lectures and memorization was used. In second revolution, it was internet-enabled learning. In 3.0, it was knowledge-producing education. Means it was always shared in classroom that the teacher is something superior and students are inferior, and teacher is pouring knowledge in head of child. Nowadays, it is not there, my dear friends. Now, student and teacher stand on equal platform because students have that much knowledge, whatever teacher is having. Being a teacher, we have to update ourselves with the need of the society. And in fourth revolution or fourth generation, it is innovative producing education. We have to create something. We have to come up with innovative ideas for teaching learning purpose. Because the fourth revolution is characterized by the fusion of technologies, including enable technologies for education 4.0. You must have heard about all these words like augmented reality, virtual reality, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, big data analytics, cloud computing, 3D printing, digital simulation and robotics. My dear teacher friends, all these things are going to incorporate in our syllabi. Tomorrow we will be dealing with all these things. There will be no wonder if robotics is used instead of all the computer laboratories. Means we never thought of that computer lab will become an integral part of any curriculum aspect or school or college's infrastructure, but it has become. In future, in coming near future, there will be robotics which will replace all these computer labs. And we have to think of big data analytics and virtual reality and Internet of Things. But at the same time, we do not believe that technology will replace teachers, but it may fundamentally change the role of teachers and lead to new teaching tools and practices. Because I always believe that there will be always need of teachers. So don't have that fear that technology will overcome teachers. It is never going to happen, my dear friends, because human brains are more superior. Whatever motivation or encouragement a teacher can give to the students, machine cannot give. So there will be always need of a teacher, and teachers will be never replaced by the technology. We just have to adapt the technology, and we have to go hand in hand with help of all these technologies. So what is teacher's role to face the challenges of COVID-19? If we think of, I will suggest four stages. The first thing is development of e-content that you have done in this faculty development program. From last 4 or 5 days, you are learning about creation of e-content, how to develop your videos, how to create it. Many of the participants, you might have created your own videos, but the next step is online teaching. How I am going to use this e-content in my classroom situation? Which platform or learning management system I am going to use? How I will go to the students and if we select any LMS, so how to use that? Then the third aspect is technical training. So technical training is needed to all the teachers. Though most of the teachers are techno savvy and they know how to use technology, still no training or no education has provided you this kind of technical training that how to teach online, how to teach in this situation where students are at home, we are at home, and we are teaching virtually to the students. So technical training is necessary. And fourth is online assessment. How we will come to know that whatever we are teaching online or whatever e-content we have developed, how our students will look at it? Are we providing whatever is according to the objective of the e-content? Are my students understanding the content which I am reproducing in the form of e-content? So we have to conduct continuous online tests, small quizzes or small assessment tools you can use, and you can conduct online assessment or small examinations of the students to get an idea exactly we are going on the right track or not. So what tools to use? Again, there is a question. You have learned so many tools in this faculty development program. So first thing is identify the age group of your students. Second thing is identify what kind of tools can be used easily, which are user friendly. Identify the kind of gadgets you have. Identify your potential as a techno savvy teacher. And then decide. It is again a teacher's creation what kind of tools to use. Because at the same time, the cultural expectation of the workforce are changing. Millennials do not expect to work at one company for their whole career, nor do they always expect to work one job at a time. They are more environmentally aware, more socially conscious, and more diverse. They recognize the changing face of society and the benefits that inclusion brings. So this is a thinking of our future generations. We have to consider this aspect of our students. Because if we taught music the way we try to teach engineering in an unbroken 4-year course, we could end up with all theory and no music. When we study music, we start to practice from the beginning and we practice for the entire time. So every subject has its own beauty. Every subject has its own methodology. Every subject has its own teaching learning process. So we have to understand while creating any video or while creating e-content that what kind of method I'm going to use for delivering this content. You must be knowing about Bloom's taxonomy. And here is one revised version of Bloom's taxonomy, where you can see from knowledge to understanding, applying, analyzing, evaluating, and the upper part is creation. So Bloom's taxonomy says that when we learn something, we have to create out of it. So while we think of learning outcomes or learning objectives, we always think on knowledge, understanding, application of the knowledge, then analyzing the things and evaluation. But the new concept is creating what knowledge you have created. So I think in e-content development, we can definitely do it. So whatever video you are creating, whatever e-content you are creating, that is your own creation, my dear friends. So you are having this Bloom's taxonomy and you will ultimately attain the objective of teaching learning. So it is very important aspect of e-content development. Let us have a small video that how our future classroom will look, because many changes are going to happen, and in these changes there might be a situation where we have to face these kind of classrooms. Let us have a small demo of it. This video is created by Daniel Nemroff, wonderfully created that how we can face the future challenges of classroom. Here you can see in the classroom, students enter without any bag or any books. They just use virtual reality, augmented reality, and without any PC or laptop, they are using and demonstrating these things. So teacher will demonstrate and student will type. There will be no books. There will be no any notebooks to write. So students will work in laboratories with small gadgets like mobile or all these devices, they will be helpful for students to learn. They will learn all the things virtually. And this is going to happen. We always feel that this will never happen in a country like India. But we never thought of that all the teachers in a country like India will teach online. You must have experienced from last 3 months. All my teacher friends, they are teaching online. So it is possible, my dear friends. So this virtual reality, augmented reality, and the laboratories will take place of all the common laboratory we have in the classroom. You can see, if you want to show some model, there is not necessity of carrying that model in the laboratory. So teacher will be able to explain, student will be able to write on their virtual laptops, and they can learn more efficiently. They can learn with more good effects of anything. Isn't it wonderful that in laboratories, if you are doing any experiment, you are using all these gadgets, and with help of some virtual reality, you are learning. So this phase of learning situation or classrooms is going to definitely come in coming near future, because it is a demand of education 4.0. It is a demand of future learning, because students will learn better. There will be a big clouds where we will store all the data, and big data analytics will be there. So we have to be ready for this, my dear friends. Because there will be shifts in pedagogy. Nowadays, we are teaching in a particular way. When we were teaching offline till last year, we have not thought of this shift in pedagogy. Trained faculty will play more role of a mentor and a facilitator. So there is more training needed. So all the faculty will get more training about how to use this. Then content delivery through flipped classes, synchronous and asynchronous, both the modes will be used. In synchronous, where students are in front of you, and in asynchronous, where you upload some material, students are not in front of you. They learn, they see, they observe, and you can assess them. Institutionalized lifelong learning instead of front loaded. That is important aspect that is going to happen. Here I am showing you some tools. You already know most of the tools. You must have heard about different video tools, but these are some other tools I would like to show you, because I have already used all these technology tools. Prezi and Haiku Deck, even Canva you can use for various presentations. Then Clockster, Flipsnack, Padlet, Story Jumper, those especially who are language teachers can use Story Jumper and Storyboard very effectively if you want to develop any story. Scratch, Animoto, Pixton can be used to have animated videos. If you are teaching in smaller classes, that means pre-primary and primary or secondary school. So all these animated videos, you just have to go on the website, and this provide you wonderful videos, wonderful pictures. You just have to insert the text and create the very creative videos. Google Forms, Google Classroom, Google Docs. I think all of you are aware about this, how to use this. Google Classroom nowadays can be used as free LMS. Broom Writer, Vizme, then ThingLink, EduCreation, Socrative, Edmodo, Schoology, Pictochar. Edmodo can be used as one of the great LMS, which is freely available, and many teachers can join this, students can join. You can have pre-recorded lectures, you can take assessment, you can post some in the classroom situation. Then OpenShot, YouTube Downloader, VLC Media Player, this can be used for editing the videos you have already learned in this FDP. Video recording can be done with various apps or various softwares like PPT VoiceOver, Screencast-O-Matic, OBS Studio, Presentation Tube. I'm just giving you a few examples. So test modes can be used to have assessment, because if you use Google Form can be used for quiz, for small answer questions, large answer, big answer questions. But test modes actually provide you a different kind of thing, where you can have a essay type questions, long answer questions, or short answer question, yes no type. wonderful website. Just visit testmos.com and explore it. You can take assessment of the student with help of it. YouTube channel, you already know, you have learned it. I will not talk on it. MindMaster, Google Forms, Blackboard.fi, Classroom.screen, all these are websites. You just go on this, explore it. If you want to learn more about it, there are many videos I have uploaded on my YouTube channel about this. So these are few more options where you can create your videos. I think all of you know about this, so I will not talk in detail about it. So let us think of LMS. You just have completed the FDP and now you will go to the classroom situation. So what learning management system you are going to use? And if your school or college have not purchased any LMS, what free LMS is available? What strength of students you have in particular class that you have to think on? You have to think of the attention span of the students, how many minutes video you are going to create, how you will use your created e-content. Ask yourself. Free platforms like Google Classroom can be used. Nowadays, for asynchronous method, Google Classroom can be used effectively. It is free. Every teacher has must have a Gmail account. With your Gmail account, you can create your classroom and you can provide that code to the students. All students get connected to it and you can use this Google Classroom in asynchronous mode. And you can upload recorded, pre-recorded videos. You can upload assignments. You can upload YouTube links. You can upload PDFs, files, text, whatever you want in Google Classroom, and that can be effectively used. So these are some of the presentations tools. Again, I will not explain here. I'll just mention the names. EduCreations, Blockster, HaikuDeck. Just go through it. Pictochart, Prezi, Vizme. Then Classroom Screen, Explain Everything. Explain Everything is a website which allows you to use videos, PDFs, sketches, and other file types for teaching and collaborating. Socrative actually provides you engage your class with flashcards, diagrams, games, and quizzes with Quizlet. An online examination can be taken on Socrative. So Boomwriter, Storyboard, and StoryJumper are a few examples where you can enhance writing abilities of students. So those who are language teachers can use this. So Google tools, you already know, Google Classroom, Google Docs, Google Sheets, Slides, and Google Forms. Google Docs can be effectively used if you it has a beautiful feature called voice typing. If you don't know how to type, you can type your content. You just have to speak in front of the mic and it automatically get typed in whichever language you want. So if you want to explore more about it, just go on youtube.com and type my name, Dr. Sandhya Khedekar, and you will be able to see various videos, digital tools, and how to teach online, how we can make our teaching learning process more effective. I have uploaded more than 30 videos on my YouTube channel. Just explore it. This is only for education purpose, my dear friends. So some references for my presentation here I am referring. And technology is a friend of education, and there is no reason to fight this trend. Right on the contrary, by incorporating digital tools in classroom, you become an effective school leader who fosters innovation. We need to be the change we want to see happen. We are the leaders we have been waiting for. My dear friends, be that change you want to see happen. It is a wonderful quote. We don't have to do different things. We have to do things differently. So that is, let us wake up. Let us have that alarming sound and let us go ahead with this new challenge and get that satisfaction of creating something. Because whenever you create your video and you look at your video, that gives a real satisfaction and you become more happy. So thank you again to all the participants, especially this college who invited me for this program. Really thankful to the principal and Morris sir. And all the best to all of you for your future online teaching learning process. And my dear teacher friends, you all can do wonders with your students. So go ahead. All the very best.